Honey, lights out.
Kentucky fans, be afraid, be very afraid. These are two of the dominant schools in the history of college basketball, and the nightcap we've been waiting for. Duke, the defending national champions, against a Kentucky Wildcats team that's reeled off six consecutive victories. Again, this has the feel of an NCAA tournament game. And if you don't believe it by looking at the crowd, if you don't believe it by looking at the players, just take a look at the head coaches, Tubby Smith and Mike Krzyzewski, two of the best in the business. And they, of course, bring their teams here. And, of course, a little bit worried about how this one could come out this early in the season. Again, this type of atmosphere, as a coach, does it worry you?
Yes, it does worry you, because what happens, everybody loves Duke up here in the North. Kentucky coming in tonight, you got to look at Duke and say, you know, they score 30% of their points off opponents' turnovers. And Carlos Boozer, the last seven games, has had five double-doubles. Kentucky has got to shoot the threes tonight. Prince and Bogans have got to show up. But my concern, if I'm Tubby Smith, is how do I guard Duke's perimeter game?
Duke's perimeter game, the threes, they will go to it very often. And, of course, the young guys underneath the hoops as well could pound it in for Duke and Kentucky, hopefully with a chance to take advantage of the size. We have looked forward to this one for the entire night. We had a great one in game number one, Temple, a big comeback against Alabama that just fell short. But right now, two of the most storied programs in college basketball meet head-to-head next.
Don't give up. Don't ever give up.
I love the speed, you know, the pace.
National championships.
What a tremendous performance by Duke.
Shoots!
Score! The Cats go to the Alamo!
I see those two uniforms, and all they stand is for greatness, greatness, greatness.
The building is filled with blue as the Wildcats of Kentucky face the number one team in the nation, the Duke Blue Devils. Duke has won 19 consecutive games. They're the defending national champions, and Mike Krzyzewski has a lifetime contract. But uneasy is the head that wears the crown? I don't think so. Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale.
All right, John, I just talked to Andre Batillo, one of the officials. He said, I've never seen this building this full. As we get ready for Duke and Kentucky, Dick, let's talk a little bit about Kentucky. Tubby's been shuffling his lineup a little bit, especially in the backcourt. He's got J.P. Blevins, and he's got Cliff Hawkins. He's been rotating them back and forth. Gerald Fitch, the other guard. We already saw one Hawkins be a star tonight. Maybe we'll see another one.
Well, I'll tell you this right now, Brad. I think the key to basketball game will be the point guard play. You have to be efficient at the point guard slot. Kentucky needs a big-time performance out of Cliff Hawkins and Blevins, who will come in and rotate with him, because they're facing the best backcourt in basketball when you talk about Duhon and Jason Williams. And you want to neutralize the ability of, I'll tell you, Duhon does a great job with defensive pressure, so Hawkins has got to create offense for Bogans and Prince. They must get the ball where they want it, and that tandem has got to put big points on the board if Kentucky is going to get to the winner's locker room.
I was going to say, immediately in June when they said they weren't going to the NBA, this became a bigger game. With more on the lineups, let's go courtside. Jay Billis, Jay.
Yo, Brad, Kentucky is one of the best rebounding teams in America, out-rebounding their opponents by over 14 per game. That's going to be a key stat to watch tonight. And as you take a look at Kentucky's lineup, you see that Tubby Smith has inserted a little bit more size in his lineup with Jules Kamara starting. You already mentioned Cliff Hawkins, going to be very important for Hawkins to handle pressure and distribute the basketball to the two leading scorers, Keith Bogans and Player of the Year candidate Tayshaun Prince. Bogans and Prince are real emphases for Duke defensively. They've got to go after those two, and the guy that's really going to be doing that on Tayshaun Prince is going to be Michael Dunleavy. Dunleavy, one of the most versatile players in the nation. He can get out and guard on the perimeter. He can also guard inside. And he handles the ball like a point guard. Michael Dunleavy will be an important player in this ballgame in guarding Tayshaun Prince. But he also has to rebound. If Duke does a good job on the defensive boards, they can do a good job against Kentucky. Rebound's going to be a key thing in this ballgame tonight. Brett?
And this is almost like a home game for not only Jason Williams and Dante Jones, but this team. 15-1 is Duke at Continental Airlines Arena, including all 10 NCAA games they played here, and they've won 5 East Regional Championships in this building. They come in perfect at 9-0. 19 straight wins is the best in college basketball, as Dick mentioned. 16 straight non-conference, 16 straight road or neutral site win.
I'll tell you, Brad, I didn't think we'd see a dynasty after the UCLA dominance, but we have to start now labeling Duke as a dynasty, what they have achieved. It's been absolutely amazing to dominate the ACC the way they have.
As Digger said, Kentucky's got to shoot better than they did in their only loss this year. That was to Western Kentucky in their opener. They have won 6 straight. How big is the game? Everybody's maybe making it bigger than it should be. And Coach K in the Hall of Fame at his 22nd season as Duke's head coach. And there's what I mentioned, 15-1 at the Meadowlands. On the other side, when asked about the importance of the game, Tubby Smith said, "I don't think they give out any national championships in December." That doesn't mean he doesn't want to win this off the
day. Oh, you better believe he wants to win. Psychologically, it's a tremendous lift anytime you can beat the number one team in America. But I agree with you, Brad. In terms of magnitude, it's obviously not a championship-quality basketball game with that at stake as would be in March. But it's still a very important clash because you got two of the prize programs in America, Duke and Kentucky. And as John Saunders said, it doesn't get much better than Tubby Smith on one side and Michael Kay on the other side.
And with all due respect to Kansas and North Carolina, maybe the most famous blue uniforms in college basketball are ready to play, and here we go. Kentucky will have first chance.
Dunleavy and Prince matched up.
Here's the steal by Duhon. All the way.
Already, there he is in the passing lane. He harasses the basketball as well as anyone. He has become the leader of this team, Prince Duhon.
Prince against Dunleavy, and Dunleavy goes to the floor for the steal. Boozer on the break against Kamara. Missed the shot, and the rebound comes off to Kentucky, and Hawkins trying to battle for it.
You can see they're going to get after it.
Kentucky got a timeout call while the ball was on the floor.
Tubby Smith didn't waste any time. Didn't like what he was watching in terms of handling the basketball. Take a look at Duhon. He comes right into the passing lane, steps in, and then he converts with the left hand. This game, when you look at it right now as you watch Duhon, I think Duhon and Williams obviously are the best backcourt in America. And here's Dunleavy with the steal off Prince.
Jay talked about the versatility of Dunleavy. He just showed it there defensively, but Boozer didn't connect. His dad is here right in the row behind the bench.
You know, it's Dunleavy. Interesting to watch also. Dunleavy's coming off an 0-for-6 from the three-point line against North Carolina A&T because he couldn't get anything off his shot.
Yeah, he hurt his ankle.
Due to the ankle injury. So it's interesting to see how he reacts because he really was struggling in that game against North Carolina A&T physically.
Let's see how the sophomore does against the sophomore. Look Hawkins at, against Duhon.
Duhon really pressures the ball.
Hawkins ties it up.
I'll tell you, he went right by him that time. Mr. Hawkins said, "I don't care about your defensive pressure." He ran right by him. He played brilliantly against Kent State Hawkins. He's got to be consistent.
Williams got in the lane and drew a foul.
As you said earlier, Jason Williams right here from New Jersey. Many thought he would go to Rutgers. In fact, he cried as you watch Hawkins. There he is getting on the inside. Hangs in the air. Good control. Left-hander. They say he cried in the car. His mom was driving down to Duke. He wanted to stay home at Rutgers. And then once he got down there, he's, I'm going to Duke.
And he just knocked down a three.
He shot down from his home down in Plainfield, New Jersey. St. Joe's High School in Metuchen is where he played high school basketball.
Hawkins pulls up against Duhon. Up with a left hand, Hawkins has four.
I tell you, Hawkins has come out early in this game and is trying to establish immediately that he's going to be a factor.
I wonder if he saw his cousin playing the first game and got a little bit excited. Boozer
is one of the key players for Duke. I really believe if you're going to beat Duke, you have to get Carlos Boozer in foul trouble.
7-4, Duke in front.
They really can't replace him. He's almost the guy that's irreplaceable on that baseline.
Here's Bogans, first time he's touched it. And here's a steal by Duhon, his second of the night, but he stepped on the sideline. Number one Duke, number eight Kentucky. Tubby Smith against Mike Krzyzewski. Two great teams against each other here in the nightcap of the Jimmy V Classic, presented by Mercedes-Benz. And our first game was a thriller near the end. 70-67, Alabama won it. And two of the winningest programs ever in this one.
Kentucky, the first winner, reach 1,800.
Dunleavy drives and dishes to Boozer.
There's his versatility, penetrator. See, that's what he gives them. He gives them a ball handler, a guy that can step to the perimeter and make the open three like he did against Arizona last year.
Now that's his second foul on Cliff Hawkins. We might see J.P. Blevins quicker than we expected. Here's Hawkins trying to stay with Dunleavy, but a nice drive. The dish over, and then the foul on Boozer by Hawkins.
The reason I said he's irreplaceable, and we talk certainly about Carlos Boozer, Brad, think about this. I know they won without him last year when he went down with his foot injury. But remember this. They had size in Shane Battier
right.
That could give him inside help. Right now, if Boozer gets in trouble, they don't have a whole lot to go to. Nick Horvat's not here, ready to play tonight. He's injured. And Casey Sanders has not progressed like they have wanted.
Yeah, Horvat is here, but in street clothes with a strained hip flexor muscle. So it's an early four-point lead for the Blue Devils.
They got to get some shots for Bogans and Prince. That's an outstanding tandem.
Prince's first touch. The three won't stay in there for him. Tough rebound underneath, though. Fitz tried to put it back up there, and now Dunleavy will clear it off to Duhon on the run.
What about Tayshaun against North Carolina? Hit the first five possessions, 5 threes.
Boozer, nice move inside.
He's got an assortment, a variety of moves inside. He's got more of a variety than Baskin Robbins has ice cream flavors. I'll tell you, he has got a bunch of moves on the interior. Carlos Boozer.
10-4 early Duke.
Oh, it's so exciting to be here. I can feel my body's got goosebumps in it, baby, looking at those jerseys.
Bogans ran over Boozer. Boozer holds his ground, a la the aforementioned Shane Battier, and here he is on the other end offensively.
Yes, sir. He knows how to post really well, uses his body exceptionally well. Great head fake. He's one of the best post-up players in America, knowing how to score down in the low box.
Blevins has checked into the backcourt for Kentucky. Again, with Hawkins, two early fouls. We might see a lot of JP here in the first half. Jason Williams, a little seam, trying it off the glass. Boozer, the stick back, blocked by Kamara.
And that's what they want out of Kamara. They want him to be a shot blocker. Sat out last year, he's had some injuries.
Prince drives all the way, rejected, no goaltending call. Whoa, I don't know about that one.
It was
Dante
close.
Jones with the blocked shot, and now a foul on the other end.
It was nope, close, Brad. Dante Jones certainly gives him a defensive presence. He's a transfer from out of Rutgers University.
Jules Kamara with a stuff on one end that prevented a Duke basket with his play on Boozer.
And that's what they want out of him, to give him that dimension. Shot blocking. Now here goes Prince to the goal. Now here comes Dante Jones from the weak side. Tough to get an angle on that. Look yep. close. Look close.
Well, considering his hand was way up on top of the box, it's kind of hard to tell. That's how high he got. Prince for three. Got it.
I'll tell you, he shot that right over Casey Sanders. He knocked down the first five threes in a row against North Carolina at 7.5 to tie a school record for a half.
And ended up with 31 points in that game.
Yeah, they blew out the Tar Heels down there by 20. Ouch, did you see Tar Heels beating Binghamton by one?
Yeah.
I was shocked when I saw that score.
And they had to stretch to get that one. Here's Jones on the other end. He missed a jam. Underneath, though, Sanders cleans up.
I wait for him to break out. I look at Casey Sanders with his quickness and his speed. Look at him at 6'10", checking Tayshaun Sprint, Prince. You see a lot of potential when you see him.
Yep. Kamara. He and Blevins play catch on the left side. Boozer knocks it out of bounds. Still Kentucky basketball. But it's Duke early by 5. 15:36 to play in the first half. Jones with a miss, but a nice follow by Sanders. And it's Duke by a handful.
The Jimmy V Classic is presented by Mercedes-Benz, located on the web at MBUSA.com, and in part by New Edge Clean Shaving Gel. It helps lift dirt and oil every time you shave.
Jimmy V Classic nightcap game. Right now, Duke leading Kentucky 12-7. And when you've got 10 national championships between these two programs, obviously you're going to be ranked number one pretty often. The series history, seventh meeting when one of the teams is ranked number one and the number one team has won each time. So well, we haven't had any upsets.
We know about that classic game in 1992. Certainly when Grant Hill made that pass to Christian Laettner and they won 104-103. And then Kentucky put the stop on Duke in 98 when Duke had a 17-point lead and took the lead for the first time against Coach K's team when Cameron Mills made his first basket in the tournament down there in St. Petersburg. And then they beat Duke at the end to go to the Final Four and win the national title in the first year for Tubby Smith.
The last time Kentucky beat a number one team was a win over UMass, and it was right in this building.
And that was after they lost to UMass in the opening game that year when Marcus Camp
did that
was
one, didn't
super.
We?
Yes, sir.
Estill underneath. Marquise Estill.
Marquise Estill has really been a guy giving him good inside-outside play all year.
What a nice bounce pass by Duhon.
What execution. I mean, Duhon to Dunleavy. Great movement without the basketball. That is classic basketball.
That pass was singing on the way to Dunleavy. Bogans way out. Rattled out a three.
They need his three to go down. Bogans from out of the Matha High School.
Duke looking to push it. Dunleavy. Williams, Duhon's wide open. He gives it up. Ewing outside, airballed it.
Going to Ewing and Sanders early in the game. Kentucky believes they got to get into Duke's bench to have a chance to win.
Kentucky is deep. Tubby's not afraid to go to that bench. Bogans double team. Three-pointer launched by Estill. And now underneath, they hit it.
There's the strong rebound into Kentucky. Plus about 14 on the opposition. Getting a second opportunity. And I think that's an area they can really attack Duke with.
Tell you, Fitch is a tough guy for being only 6'3". He's not afraid to crash the boards.
He's an outstanding defensive player. He'll really get up in your face. Very tenacious. I got a feeling these clubs are going to hang around a long time come March, baby. I really believe that.
Duhon, we talked about his passing ability.
Oh,
look at that.
Look
thing.
At that, right off the dribble. Great bounce pass. You'll see a pass made on this floor here by a guy by the name of Jason Kidd will make that kind of pass. As we watch that, Dunleavy cutting without the basketball. Looks like the ankle is okay. 9 assists a game in his last 3 games. Duhon has become the leader. They're putting the ball in his hand, and they're letting Williams play a lot without the basketball, saving his legs and allowing him to score, Jason.
55 assists. Duhon had coming into this game, and this now the 10th ball game of the year for Duke. Williams goes back outside. Pull-up jumper. That's a tough shot. Dante Jones couldn't hit it. Here comes Kentucky. Estill, nice pass from Prince. Boozer gets the block.
What a great angle on Carlos Boozer recovering in defensive transition.
Boozer's not been a big shot blocker this year so far.
Well, no, he's not that kind of player, but here he is with the hustle and good timing. The shot blocker they have is Casey Sanders. They got Boozer right here hooking him. They got Boozer hooking him. That's smart strategy. Tubby Smith going inside, trying to attack Carlos Boozer. I really believe he's the key guy they cannot replace. Last year, they were able to make up when he went out with Shane Battier, who had the versatility to go inside.
Kentucky can cut the lead to one if they score this trip. Prince back it in, and a foul is Dante Jones trying to stay with him.
As you talked already about the rebounding, and that's really the key for Duke. Mike Krzyzewski spent a lot of time at practice today talking about grabbing defensive boards. They've got to send all 5 guys to the glass because Kentucky has such outstanding offensive rebounders, especially their guards. Guys like Keith Bogans and Gerald Fitch can really go after the glass. That will be a key tonight, is who controls the boards.
Prince Drop Dunleavy. Missed the three. Esto with a follow.
And as he's rebounding the fast right there on the inside. Look at this. They don't get back.
Here's a rejection. Cruiser went up and Prince knocked it out of there.
Oh, what a motion and intensity on this floor.
Kentucky can take the lead if they score. They do.
Hello, the Kentucky Cats fans. Go wild, baby. The Dukies are in for a battle here tonight. The Dukies are in for a battle tonight, Mr. Nestler.
Caruth knocks down a three from the corner. It's a 7-0 Kentucky run.
It all started with that magical word, the block shot. And as Boozer thinks he has a layup, and there comes the block shot.
Then they go the other way to the baseline of Caruth. That was an excited coach.
Yes, sir. Look at the intensity. He'll be intense on the 29th also when Mr. Petito comes to his house down at Rupp Arena, Louisville, Kentucky. Two special programs here. Kentucky with seven national championships, as you said, Brad. Duke with three national titles. Going for an unprecedented this year. Four consecutive ACC tournaments in a row. They've won the ACC regular season five times in a row.
So for the first time tonight, Duke plays from behind. And Daniels or Estill gets Jones. I'm not sure which they're going to call it out.
Dante Jones attacking the basket. He's a transfer, the second transfer Mike Krzyzewski's ever taken. Both have been from New Jersey. Dante and also Rashad McLeod.
He came the way of
St. John's. McLeod, he came the way of Rutgers, Brad.
2 years he started at Rutgers. Average over 13 points and four rebounds a game.
The Scarlet Knight have won eight games in a row. They lost their first two. Gary Waters has them winning right now. They've won eight in a row.
Dante in front of the hometown fans can tie this thing up.
Guys, one of the important facets of this ball game for Kentucky is transition defense. They've done a good job so far of getting back in transition and identifying shooters and then rotating towards those shooters. They've got to continue to do that in addition to being strong with the basketball and handling Duke's pressure.
You know, Caruth made that shot. In the last game he played, he had wide open looks and he wouldn't shoot the ball. Yeah, they thought he was pouting a little bit. He was sulking because he was really upset with PT playing time. And his high school coach said, hey, he's got to make an adjustment, Steve Smith, and realize there are a lot of good players and your playing time will come. He makes a shot like he just did. He'll get a lot of playing time.
You got that right. Nice look, and he's got another basket.
Nice cut without the ball. He played at Oak Hill Academy. He's got a lot of confidence in his ability, Mr. Caruth.
Daniels with a dish, Caruth with his second basket. And now Boozer backing in. Wheels on the baseline. Estill cut him off with the pass. Williams for three. Got it.
What a great job of reversing the ball. Boozer recognizes the double team, brings it out to Duhon, who swings it to his teammate, Jason Williams.
Williams with two threes now, and he gives Duke a one-point lead. Prince doubled. Nice look, but a better defensive play by Boozer to knock it out of the paint.
They really play with two point guards. When you have Duhon and Jason Williams, you have like two leaders, two guards who can play either slot.
Dunk a shame, darling, dunk a shame. Thank you for all the joy.
Find great values at the Mercedes 100th Anniversary Event, our anniversary gift to you.
Duke by a point, just under 12 to go in the first half. Great fundamental basketball so far, Dick.
Well, you know, Brad, you're going to get free and get opportunities if you move without the basketball, and Kentucky's been doing a good job. We see an example right here. Freezer right here. The ball's out top, first starts at the circle. We're going to see a backdoor cut by Caruth. They're going to see Caruth right coming up, backdoor. There's the open look. And there's the layup, cut without the basketball. Now you talk about fundamentals, moving the basketball, recognizing the double team. Now the ball goes inside the Boozer. Now watch, they do a great job running at Boozer to take away his drive. But now he kicks it back out to Duhon, who doesn't waste any time swinging it to Jason Williams, and he knocks it down. You know, I talked about earlier, they have two point guards. I only think there's one point guard in America better than Jason Williams. Only one.
And he's gotta playing, be in the NBA.
He's playing right in his building. And his name is Jason Kidd.
Right?
That's about it, man. Jason Kidd. Gary Payton, maybe, but Gary getting up there in years. Jason Kidd, to me, is probably the only one I would take over Mr. Williams.
With Dick Vitale, Jay Billis, John Sauters, Digger Phelps, I'm Brad Nessler. It's nice to have you along with us. This is the seventh Jimmy V Classic. This is a nightcap game. It's number one against number eight. We had a three-pointer. Alabama held on to beat Temple in our first game, 70-67. And right now, the bench is doing a great job for Kentucky. Duke's only basket was from Casey Sanders. But Carruth has five off the bench.
We expect that. Tubby's going to go to his bench, Brad, and he's going to get more help. He's going to rotate a lot of people. And that's one of their strategies, to really try to wear Duke down at the end of this game.
Williams, great crossover dribble, gets it over to Boozer.
There's point guard play right there. A little 3D man. You drive, you draw, you dish the rock to the open shooter, and right there, Boozer shoots the little facing jump shot, the medium range jumper.
A Duke by three.
Good spacing by Kentucky.
Blevins almost lost the ball. He's got Duhon on him.
He's not going to beat you with speed, Blevins, but he's a kid capable of making open shots.
Estill going to take a three. Are you kidding me?
That's it. He can make that shot. That's what makes him so dangerous. He can go inside, outside. Marquise the Magnificent.
Well, that's only the third three he's tried this year, and he knocks that one down. Tied at 21, thanks to Marquise Estill, the 6'9", 240-pound junior who did the unthinkable.
There he is now shooting that jumper. You know, last year he was making that shot regularly from out on a perimeter. That's what gives him that versatility versus the other big players, Kamara and Marvin Stone. And remember this, Kentucky took a big hit when they lost Jason Parker. Big, strong, low post player. We wish
out for the year with an ACL.
Yeah, we wish nothing but the best in recovering, Jason.
Here's Bogans, who's barely touched it tonight. And runs into a double team, and Boozer just took it from him.
Yeah, Bogans got himself into a bad position on the floor.
Williams, three. Got it.
Big time player, my friends. America's premier talent, Jason Williams. Jammin' Jason is the best in the land.
3-point lead, courtesy of the three-pointer by Williams, and now playing defense. Forces a turnover.
I tell you, super strong body physically. Watch Jason Williams now defensively, showing that he's not a one-dimensional player. Oh, there's the little push off. He gets the call. He's excited with that. He also is a great salesman. He was the guy that convinced Dante Jones to transfer to Duke.
Not bad, old buddies from Jersey.
He said they almost all went to Rutgers.
Dunleavy on a drive up high off the glass, and a whistle and a foul.
Anytime there is a turnover for Duke, they want to look for an opportunistic three. Here you can see off the steal by Carlos Boozer, Keith Bogans not really strong with the ball. Immediately they look for an opportunistic three in transition. Mike Krzyzewski thinks that those are deflating plays. They try to do that when they get an offensive rebound and off of a steal.
Psychologically, they break you down.
Dunleavy for three, and he got
it. Sir, he was like that on fire in the final game against Arizona. His dad says, that's my guy. He was 0-for-6 against North Carolina A&T.
He hit three in 45 seconds in that game Dick is talking about against Arizona. Talk about the most exciting 9 points in less than a minute in that game. Estill, nice kick outside to Bogans.
Bogans got to make shots. He didn't make shots against Western Kentucky, and they went to the loser's locker room at home.
Daniels will try outside. Dunleavy trying to keep it alive. Fitch picks it up, and he'll go to the hole.
Great play by Fitch. He takes the ball on the offensive rebound, goes to the glass with tenacity, beating Duke on the glass. Oh, nice fade.
His man in the air, trying to go baseline with a pass, and the ball's knocked out in front.
He walked. He lifted his pivot foot. At 6'9 and a half, he gives you a special player. He can shoot the three, he can penetrate. Coach K, a Hall of Famer and a super humanitarian. He, John Sauters, and I worked together on that He Foundation Golf Classic. And here's Dunleavy calling for the ball early, gets it, and knows how to finish it.
Boy, and he is not a skinny little kid anymore. As you said, 6'9 and a half, almost 6'10. He's put on about 20 more pounds of muscle in the past year. Bogans on a drive. There's some muscle. Didn't connect, though, and Fitch. nearly had another rebound. Jones going the other way. And he's fouled by Prince. Tayshaun picks up his first foul. SportsCenter follows our game. We have 8:29 left in this half. Downhill for Grant. Grant Hill injured again. Rangers off their rocker. The Cardinals trying to replace Big Mac. All that and more coming up on SportsCenter. Stuart Scott and Linda Cohn will be along.
That's a nice little locker room. Rocker and Carl Everett over in Texas, the Rangers. My guy Alex Rodriguez is going to love that combination.
Things momentarily settle down. Duke by four, 8:20 left in the half.
And the man defense by Kentucky. Always special under Tubby Smith. Did a great job defensively at Tulsa, at Georgia.
Wow, what a look by Dunleavy. The pass was too good to Sandy.
It's great when you got a kid with that kind of size and that vision to make those kind of plays. That's very rare to have 6'10s that can play on a perimeter and find open people.
Two starters on the Duke bench, as you saw, on Williams and Boozer.
Kentucky's got to take advantage right now with Boozer on that sideline.
Kamara faces up against Sanders, now spins to the baseline.
Nice little baseline jump shot. They're waiting for him to break out. To break out and show that potential he demonstrated 2 years ago.
2 years ago, he averaged over 7 points and almost five boards a game. And now Duhon slips and slides, and that's another Duke turnover. With 7 minutes and 43 seconds remaining, first half. It's Duke hanging on to a two-point lead. The seventh Jimmy V Classic presented by Mercedes-Benz. Duke, the number one team in the country, leading eighth-ranked Kentucky 27-25. The V Foundation for Cancer Research, we welcome your calls. 1-800-4-JIMMY-V. Don't give up. Don't ever give up. And operators are standing by right now to take your donations as we continue our fight against cancer. And we invite you to call. A lot of folks already have tonight, and we hope that everybody keeps on calling.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Jimmy V's legacy to me is going to be remembered as courageous battle against cancer, not winning the national title in 83. You heard earlier tonight with Joe Torre, Mario Lemieux, right. Lance Armstrong all said the effect that he had on their lives in battling cancer. Call that number, please, 1-800-4-JIMMY-V. Oh, what a monster mash. What a dunk. This could be the wake-up call for Jules Kamara, baby. He has come to play tonight.
That drive started in Senegal, his home country.
Yes,
sir. Tied at 27.
Played there this summer.
The national team. Here's Dunleavy. Long range. Missed it. Fitch, another rebound.
These Kentucky kids are here ready to face this challenge.
What a tough pass. Caruth is open. Got it.
He can shoot the basketball. That was his reputation coming out of high school. He says, get me the run. Get me that run, baby.
Played at Oak Hill, but before that, a star at College Park, Georgia. And here's a block shot by Prince. I thought Williams was going to put it up again.
His size really bothered Jason Williams there in that position. Duke a little rattled right now against Kentucky. Kentucky's pushing and attacking Duke, as you see right here.
Prince out of control, walked with it. That's not what they wanted to do on that possession, but that last basket gave them only their second lead of the night.
What I have seen early this year in the 2 months that we've had basketball played in the first segment of this year, as you watch Kamara with the dunk. If I had to say right now, my final four teams, I think certainly of Duke, obviously a great team this year in college basketball. I love Maryland, the Terps. I think even though they had that slip early, Gary Williams got himself a dynamite club with experience.
Like Kansas?
I love Kansas. I love the Jayhawks, and I love Kentucky. And right behind them, I would have the Gators of Florida breathing right there with these four, and Illinois possibly in the Super Six.
It's not a bad group. Boozer had it stripped and stolen.
See, here's Tayshaun now saying, look, I can handle the ball too, Mr. Dunleavy, at your size. What a matchup these two players. Very versatile. Two of the most versatile in America.
French takes it over Dunleavy. And Kamara, trying to keep it alive, is fouled by Boozer. That'll be two on Carlos Boozer. Coming up tomorrow night, the Devils and the Rangers will hook up on Wednesday night hockey. It'll be their first meeting since the Rangers won in overtime, 4-3. Mike Richter had 46 saves in that one. We're in the Devils' home building here, and that's why our feet are freezing because we're over the top of ice.
I thought it was me. My feet are like ice.
Yeah, that's what Lorraine tells you every night. But this is because we have ice underneath it.
Luke is on the floor now with Boozer out. Reggie Love, the football player.
In and out. The aforementioned clears the glass.
See, right now, Duke has no inside game. Look at that tip. I tell you, Reggie Love, are you kidding me? Steps in a Duke uniform and becomes contagious. He played well last year at times.
He made his impact known in a hurry. DeMar wheels on the baseline. Rebound, Dante Jones.
Did take advantage of that possession with Boozer on the sideline. You got to recognize that.
Three-pointer rims out. Love had a hand on it.
Love has been very active inside. He's given the Dukies a lot of love, man. I'll tell you that. As Boozer sitting on that sideline. You know, he got in foul trouble in a game against Seton Hall, and they struggled to win that at the end. He fouled out against Stanford last year. They got beat. He went out against Maryland with the injury, and they got beat. And there's Reggie Love. Look at him tipping up there. It must have been so frustrating to go to a football season. I don't think they won a game, did they?
They haven't in 2 years.
They haven't won in 2 years. Wow.
He's winning enough on a basketball court, though, huh?
Yeah, so he looks at the numbers in basketball and gives him a pretty good record.
Stone, tough move, drew a foul.
Smart possession right there by Tubby and his kids. Going inside with Boozer on the sideline. You know, I look at that Kentucky program. It's incredible. 7 national championships, winningest program ever. You think about 13 Final Fours, 42 NCAA tournaments, 41 SEC championships, 10 seasons with 30 or more. Tubby is part of one great program.
Stone misses a free throw.
Become the giant in coaching as you look at Coach K.
Most wins in a 4-year stretch ever, and the previous 2 best were Kentucky teams. How about that?
Yeah, Kentucky there when they 3 years in a row went to the final game, 96, 97, and 98, winning the national titles in 96 and 98.
Last year, Duke winning the title 35-4.
Lost to Lute Olson in 97, a man that belongs in the Hall of Fame, Lute Olson. What a job he has done at that program in Arizona. As Dunleavy now, showing he can play with his back to the basket as well.
Dunleavy trying to get a shot away, and he's bumped.
Just shows great basketball IQ there. He knows his teammates on the sideline, Carlos Boozer, so therefore they have no interior game. He takes his ability on the inside. He says, I know I can play outside. Look at the head fake to draw the contact, but he goes inside to give a little post presence.
Dunleavy, one of the co-captains of this team.
Two of my favorite places to visit for basketball, down at Cameron Indoor Stadium with the Cameron Crazies, and whenever you walk into Rupp Arena, the magic that exists there. You know what's really great going to happen? Kaywood Ledford, they're going to name the floor after him against Louisville. Kaywood, certainly one of the great broadcasters, did a phenomenal job, lost his life in a battle against cancer.
Passed away in September.
I hope the people down Syracuse hear what they're doing down in Kentucky and do it for Jimmy Boeheim, named that court down there at the Carrier Dome.
Duke by 1. Caruth for the lead. Got it.
Are you serious? He's saying, Coach, I told you I deserve some PT, Coach. I can shoot the rock. That was his reputation. What a half he's had, Brad.
He's got 10 points. Duhon tried to answer with a 3, and it didn't go.
Parker out of the lineup means that Stone's got to be big for them on the inside.
Duhon comes up with a loose ball.
They haven't been able to get anything from Bogans yet tonight. They wanted to carry.
Duhon almost palmed it, hit a dead spot in the floor or something. That ball just took off on it. Bob Donato made the hand signal right in front of us that he kept his hand on top of the ball, even though it was a high dribble. Dunleavy wheels on the baseline. Prince is all alone for the rebound.
Ayshon Prince, last year's best player in the SEC.
Whoa, there's a bump. Reggie thought he was back on the football field.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned earlier about them losing in terms of playing a number one. I think about it early in the year when they beat Mass, they came into this building. It was in 90, 98. They came into this, 96 rather, came in this building and beat UMass.
Kentucky leading by 2.
I was in a Final Four.
Kaywood would love this game, wouldn't he? Speaking of him, we'll talk about that when we come back.
I wanted to seek you guys out because all the Kentucky fans would be listening. And just to say how much empathy we have as a staff and team for the Kentucky kids. They were absolutely sensational.
Alex, you...
From Philadelphia, this is Keywood Ledford saying goodbye. Well, here's Coach Mike Krzyzewski. Great game, Mike.
My respect for their team and their kids was at the ultimate level.
I wanted to seek you guys out because all the Kentucky fans would be listening, and just to say how much empathy we have as a staff and team for the Kentucky kids. They were absolutely sensational.
And of course, that Mike Krzyzewski talking with Keywood after his final broadcast in a 104-103 overtime win. Most people consider maybe the greatest game ever played in college basketball. And those were Mike's words on the Kentucky radio network following that game. And of course, our buddy Ralph Hacker took over as the play-by-play voice, and he is now since retired as well.
That's when Woods made that shot with 2.5 seconds. It looked like Kentucky was going to dance, go on to the Final Four, and all of a sudden, Christian Laettner from Grand Hill.
We'll talk more about that one as the game goes along, but we got a dandy on our hands right here. 33-31, a walk on Jones.
Jones really trying to play at a level where he's just too quick. He's right now not playing within himself because he's at home and he's trying to impress
some people. Don't you think he's at home and he's just pushing too hard?
Yeah, he really is. He's playing a step quicker than he should. Just relax and let the game come to him.
Caruth, he's playing at a pretty good level.
He hasn't missed a shot, Brad. I don't believe he's missed a shot. I mean, Caruth has really stepped up and made for Bogans. I mean, he's 5 for 6. I'll take that back. He's missed one shot.
He's got 12 points.
Tubby, what a job he did at Georgia in his short tenure there as well before coming to Kentucky.
He takes everybody he coaches at least to the Sweet 16, if not farther.
Well, he took his peers. They'll all tell you, flat out understands the game.
Cruiser straight up, didn't get the roll. Caruth the rebound. 4-point lead for Kentucky.
Caruth and Kamara have stepped up big here in the first half for Kentucky.
Stone almost lost a handle. Now he wheels on the baseline. Missed the hook shot. And the foul is going to be on the backside from Chuck Hayes. Trying to get a rebound.
They really like Chuck Hayes.
Coming up at halftime, John and Digger will be along for SportsCenter in-game. We'll have more on Jimmy V. Look back at the Alabama Temple game, and that thing got a little bit crazy at the end. And there the fellas are. Coats off, feet up.
And they're taking life easy. Hey, look at our boss right here. Are you kidding me? And look at Howie. That's Schwab. He's the guy that gives us all the research. That's Brian Sheriff up there. He gives us our assignments. Oh, wow. Howie Schwab sitting there like a king, I tell you. He's like a king.
Dunleavy at the free throw line rips it.
What a superb first half this early in the season. Remember, the season really heats up when we go down in January. As you look at Carlos Boozer on the sideline. You know, I think of Duke, they've had, when you think about players of the year, Johnny Dawkins in 86, Danny Ferry, 89, Christian Laettner in 92, Elton Brand, 99, Jason Williams, Shane Battier. It's unbelievable.
Remember, Jason Williams was the NABC Player of the Year last year. Shane Battier won the other ones, and Williams trying to become a back-to-back winner of Players of the Year. And the only guys that have done that are guys like Oscar Robertson and Jerry Lucas.
Wow.
Lou Alcindor, Bill Walton, David Thompson, and Ralph Sampson.
Those are
that's pretty good
names.
Company.
Are you kidding me? Those are pretty good names. If I had to pick my five best players of all time, as you look at Johnny Dawkins in college basketball, one of them, I can tell you right now, I'm talking college now, David Thompson at the small forward slot. He was a human highlights film at North Carolina State.
Duhon picked up that foul. Boozer checks back. And Caruth, who's been the offensive catalyst for the Cats tonight at the free throw line.
You know, against Kentucky State, I'm going to point out to you, he wouldn't shoot the basketball. He had wide open looks, and he was pouting and sulking. He was really upset about playing time. Steve Smith, his coach, really said, hey, time to adjust, time to get really acclimated. You look at those numbers,
13 points.
Boy, he just rips a line drive, 14 points.
He's going to get a lot of playing time now.
Guys, a couple of things that Kentucky has done extraordinarily well. Tubby Smith, one of the best defensive coaches in America. His team playing outstanding half-court defense. They are communicating very well. They're getting out to shooters. And on the offensive end, they are beating Duke off the dribble, one area where I think Duke can be vulnerable.
Wow. Jason Williams just went around the corner like he was in a sports car.
I think he heard our guy, Jay Billis. I think he was listening. He said, well, I'll show you if I can get to the rack on these guys. And he just exploded to the goal, and no one really rotated over to give him any help in that possession.
Jason's got 11. Caruso got 14. They're your two leading scorers.
The 11 you expect from Jason.
Whoa! Uh-oh!
Right down the lane, baby!
Nice look by Chuck Hayes, and Estill did the rest.
Estill inside, showing his ability to get to the basket. He's looking at the intensity of Michael Krzyzewski.
Jason Williams off the mark on a three.
That's an area he still has to work on. Shot selection. He has a tendency to take some bad shots.
Oh, there's a knife in the guts. It's a two-pointer by Bogans, though. I thought it was a three.
They need Bogans to step up. He and Mr. Prince are the veterans. They're the leaders. And those passionate Kentucky fans roar.
They're up six. Biggest advantage for the Cats.
Oh, they just lose it. They had them wide open.
Less than a minute and a half. Dunleavy. He'll try to quiet the crowd. Does.
Big time shot right there by Mr. Dunleavy. I told you early in this game, the Dukies are going to have to lace them up and really come to play tonight. This is a talented, deep Kentucky team.
Dunleavy leads Duke with 12. Jason Williams with 11. And it's a three-point game.
They have not been able to handle this kid.
Carew trying to pack it inside. He did get the pass there, and it's good for two.
Nice look by Carew. The shot wasn't available.
Hayes scores underneath. His first basket. Five-point game. Final possession.
They're all standing up. They got a lot of Kentucky fans here, boy. They follow their catch. Hayes gives them a lot of toughness.
Jason Williams inside. No foul call. Boozer the stick back.
Carlos Boozer with a good offensive rebound.
And that's going to do it.
What a half.
What a half.
Super half, Brad. Super basketball.
First three games, 12 points for Rashad Carruth. And he has come to life tonight to lead all scorers in the ball game and leading Kentucky with 14. Let's go to Jay Billis.
With assistant coach David Hobbs. David, your game plan coming into this game was to get back in transition, find shooters, and also to pound the glass. Do you think you did a good job of that?
We've done a pretty good job of that, Jay. We've not limited that three-point shots the way we should. We've done a pretty good job of taking away the easy transition baskets. We've pounded boards pretty well. We've let them get inside a couple of times, but overall, we've had pretty good effort.
After a terrific first half, what do you say to your team at halftime?
Well, we just have to say that the most insignificant thing in a game is the score at halftime. We just have to race the board, start it all over. We've got to have the same kind of energy that we had in the first half, and if we do that, we'll have a shot.
David, thank you. Good luck in the second half. Brad, back to you.
Remember, Tubby Smith said they don't give out championships in December. This is a championship-caliber game, folks. Halftime, Kentucky 43. The top-ranked team in the country, 40. John Saunders and Digger Phelps. SportsCenter in-game coming up next.
The Jimmy V Classic is presented by Mercedes-Benz, located on the web at MBUSA.com.
Big-time player, my friend. Oh, what a monster mash. What a dunk.
That young man may have been afraid to go near the closet, but I guarantee you he will not be coming out until this game is over. After the way that first half went, 43-40, Kentucky has the lead. We talked about the offensive rebounding of Kentucky, but depth also might become an issue in this game.
Yeah, John, I'm impressed. When you look at minutes played, Kentucky's bench, not one guy went 20 minutes. Duke played three players the full half. The question will be, will Duke have enough juice the last 5 minutes of this game to pull off a victory? I think the edge right now goes to Kentucky because of the way Tubby subbed in the first half. Watch Jason Williams, though. You know, he didn't come home to lose, and he wants to get this win. He may go off for 20 himself the second half.
It seems like any time Duke has found themselves in a game like this over the last year or so, they have found a way to pull it out. We'll find out in the second half right now. Let's join Brad and Dick.
All right, John and Digger, thanks, guys. And, you know, you look at that first half, so exciting. And Digger talked about the bench strength of Kentucky. Not only did they play a lot of minutes, they outscored the starters. And if they keep doing that, Duke's got their hands full. You said that in the first couple minutes of the ballgame.
Well, you know, Brad, we talked about, I thought that the bench would be a factor. We talked about that early in the game, how fatigued that Kentucky wanted to get them into their bench. Kentucky's a very deep basketball team, and they also dominated on the glass. But what a performance they got out of Rashad Caruth. I don't think anybody in Kentucky could have expected that kind of performance here in the first half.
He put on a show, some line drives, some rainbows for three underneath. Also did a good job on the boards. But his shooting was sensational, and he ended up with 14 first half points, and he leads all scorers, in fact, with those 14. There's the story statistically for Kentucky on the season, only shooting, I should say, shooting 48%. That isn't bad, but 55, they will take that any old day. Eight turnovers for each team in the ballgame, and Caruth the leading scorer, as I mentioned, with 14. Duke, statistically, in the first half, shot 47%, which is just about their seasonal average. Jason Williams had 11 points. Mike Dunleavy actually was the leading scorer, as he had 12. Now let's see if Jay Billis, who has spent a lot of time at Duke as both a coach and a player, thinks that they're going to change things up at halftime. Jay?
Well, Brad, Mike Krzyzewski raised his voice a tad in the locker room at halftime, and he talked about toughness, that Kentucky had out-toughed Duke in a number of different areas, especially on the glass, going after loose balls. And in guarding Rashad Caruth, they were not tough in trying to get out to him, and Caruth just had his way getting open shots. And when he got open shots, he knocked him down, the sign of an outstanding player, Brad.
Raised his voice a tad. I bet he did. Well put, Jay Billis.
I tell you, Jay, did he ever raise the voice when you were playing?
That's all he did, Dick, was raise his voice at me.
There's the bench story for Kentucky. 10 of 15 from the floor. A lot of that was Caruth. But also, Estill was not considered a starter, and he had 9 points. Stone had one, and Chuck Hayes had a deuce. And he's going to start the second half where he began the game, on the bench. That is Rashad Caruth. And here comes Kentucky with a three-point lead, and we're underway in the second half.
Man-to-man defense by Duke. Nothing fancy, just tough man-to-man.
Nice look down low by Prince. Kamara lost it and moved to the basket. Dubby Smith wanted a foul call on Mike Dunleavy and didn't get it.
Every coach wants a foul call against the opposition. Oh, nice punch.
Prince all alone.
Great look. They're really moving well without the basketball. That's a lost art in college basketball.
Each team led by six at one point in the first half, and we had five tied. Now it's Kentucky by five. Dunleavy trying to cut into that lead. Missed a three. Tough rebound underneath by Jones. He missed a reverse layup.
Guys, Duke plays denial defense. They get out in passing lanes, and on this out-of-bounds play, Tayshaun Prince really used that denial against Mike Dunleavy, taking him back door. The ball was in the middle of the court, so there was no weak side help. That is outstanding execution by Kentucky.
Yeah, real great movement without that basketball. Prince, a veteran player, he's so much more confident. You can see in his game now than it was in the past. He had a great year last year, though, was the SEC Player of the Year.
That foul, by the way, was on Bogans. For Kentucky, Dunleavy stripped by Fitch, got it back, scoops it out. Here's the outside jumper by Jones that won't go.
Dante Jones really having a tough night, Brad. Really struggling out here offensively.
Hawkins behind the back and then puts it up. And tipped back in by Kamara.
And there's Kentucky dominating out of glass. They dominated the first half, getting second and third opportunities.
Biggest advantage of the night for Kentucky.
Duke not blocking out.
Duhan almost walked with it. Comes free to Dunleavy.
Buckets, pretty good defensive player, matched up on Williams.
Williams uses his body well. Kamara stuffs it out of there.
Jules Kamara has really stepped his game up here today. He is really showing the young man that demonstrated that potential as a diaper dandy. Look at Coach K. He's standing up. He knows he's got to get these charges ready to play.
Kentucky was saying, hey, you know, that was off Duke. And Andre Petillo overruled the original call, so it does go out of bounds to Kentucky.
I would try to go at Boozer. I would try to get Boozer in a little trouble, trying to bring the ball to the inside.
French fades over Dunleavy. Fitch, that's his fifth rebound. Five on four.
Right over.
Alone. Kamara stripped out of there by Dunleavy, but he's going to pick up a foul.
Jules Kamara really working on the glass. Dunleavy with the foul. You look at Johnny Dawkins on its sideline, a player of the year under Mike Krzyzewski, former NBA player. Tubby Smith. Watch Jules Kamara. He's going to rotate over on Jason Williams. He comes from the weak side with the left hand with a good angle for the block shot.
That's not the first one he's had tonight.
I'll tell you, he's really earning playing time now. This kid was really, if you look at the stats, a non-factor earlier in the year.
Kentucky has blocked.
He has gotten a wake-up call here tonight.
Kentucky has blocked seven shots tonight. Kamara missed the second.
As Chris Duhon said, he said it so accurately, we take everybody's hit. Everybody plays at another level when they see our jerseys. And the same for Kentucky.
Jason Williams, great drive, couldn't finish it in part because of Kamara.
Yes, Kamara rotated over again. That's a shot change. I tell you, they got the most compassionate, passionate fans. Kentucky, they travel all over America. They're in the hotel lobbies. They're here tonight in blue, as you see Kamara rotating over. He's just owning the lane inside. He's like a human eraser.
6'11", 225-pound junior has had a sensational game. Bogans throws a shoulder in. Dunleavy slides into the basket support.
They missed that call right there because he definitely charged into Dunleavy. They've been able to contain. And really,
I think Keith's a little frustrated. He's only got 2 points.
Yeah, they've been able to contain him. He only had two against North Carolina. They won big.
Nice dish. Hawkins to Fitch.
Hawkins to Fitch. They're unheralded, but Hawkins playing well. In the minutes, look at him. Little on the challenge. He says, come on, Chris Duhon.
It's a 10-point Kentucky lead.
I told you earlier tonight, Brad, they were in for a war. You could see it the way the game started. This Kentucky team is determined.
Jones gets it down to Boozer. Offensive foul.
I think that's three on him.
Indeed it is.
I think that's three, and he's the one guy they can't afford to go to the sideline. In the past, they've had problems. Last year, losing to Stanford. This year,
here comes a Duke second five.
He sent in a message. He is not happy with the effort of his kids. It will not be long, but he's sending in a message.
He did not look up from that pose when any of the other five came by him. Not one word. I'm talking about Mike Krzyzewski.
Yes, sir. He sent in a message out that he's not pleased with their effort here tonight.
Foul's going to be on Buckner.
But I'll tell you, down 10, you can't wait too long and let this blow up to 15, 16.
Buckner picks up his first foul as Duhon and Dunleavy and Williams, and on down the bench they go. Boozer.
See, now Kentucky can't get relaxed right now. Their starters got to make like they're looking at Jason Williams and Dunleavy and Boozer, and they got to play with the same focus and the same intensity.
If they do, they might be able to put some serious hay in the barn. But right now, the Duke five that came in has picked up the defense.
And they like the hay in the barn in Lexington.
Feed those thoroughbreds.
They got a lot of horses, and they got them also in their basketball uniform, a lot of thoroughbreds.
Kept alive by Bogan. Second shot clock for Kentucky this trip. Christensen steps out on Prince and fouls him.
I don't think Mike Krzyzewski's going to wait and maybe one more possession at the most and get back to starters.
Maybe till the TV timeout, huh?
There they are, very active inside. Kentucky kids really out scrapping and out clawing Duke, and you don't see that often.
I love Fitch's rebounding ability. The way he crashes a glass at 6'3". Here he is offensively, trying to spin a pass inside. It's kicked away by Ewing. And that's a fresh shot clock again for Kentucky, and they still haven't put a shot up.
Well, you know, Duke twice this year has come from behind. They were 9 down against Ball State, and they went down against Seton Hall and had a really fight to get the W.
Hawkins trying to feed Kamara, guys.
I tell you, Jules Kamara and Cliff Hawkins playing exceptional basketball. Great two-man game. You got to salute these cats the way they're playing here tonight.
The Jewel of Senegal right now put on a show.
If he gives them that kind of ability on a consistent basis, remember, they're not getting anything out of Bogut yet tonight. You know he's capable. Oh, the Cats fans are going bananas. They're going bananas.
Kentucky a 9-0 run this half. They lead by 12. Jules Kamara, a starter tonight. And man, is he acting like one. Reason to cheer for Kentucky. The eighth-ranked team in the country's got a lead by 12, under 16 minutes to go. You can obviously watch the games here on ESPN with Jay and Dick and John and Digger and I, but did you know you can log on to ESPN.com for a webcast with Doug Brown, Bob Valvano, and Andy Katz. They answer your questions. They already have answered your questions, obviously, at halftime. The question is, how many times have we seen an entire different five come in to play for the Duke Blue Devils? Jay, you got an answer for that one?
I have seen him do this before, Brad, in 1992 against Clemson when Duke was getting beaten pretty badly. He took all the starters out and put in the bench players, and the bench players made a little bit of a run in that last time out. What Mike Krzyzewski told his team is Kentucky is still getting every rebound. They're just tougher than we are. And it's really a toughness check right now for Duke. Kentucky is tougher. They're out executing them. They're out playing them.
Ewing got a basket to cut it back to 10. Prince, deep three. Kamara almost tipped it in. And in battling with Love to get it back, he walked.
Ewing made a great baseline drive. He's from out of Texas and an outstanding high school player. In fact, his high school team won the state championship 2 years in a row with TJ Ford, now starring for Texas.
He's the only scholarship freshman on this Duke team, but he's one of six McDonald's All-Americans. But when you add these two teams together, we got enough McDonald's All-Americans to open a drive-thru window. I think.
You have no Wendy hamburgers out there, huh?
No, it's all Golden Arches here tonight.
I'll tell you one thing, they got another six coming in next year.
Bogans runs into Buckner. Or Buckner into Bogans. He picks up his second foul.
I mean, those guys are thirsty. They can't wait to come in. He's got them so hungry on that sideline.
They're all standing up.
They're all standing up. They're saying, like, Coach, please give us the nod. We want to go back out there. We don't like this pine time. Jason said, I'm home. Andre Jones says, I'm home in Jersey. Coach K says, you got to show me toughness, man. You got to show me toughness. You wear that Duke uniform. You play with a lot of passion.
We'll see how long they stay over there. In the meantime, Kentucky has not stretched the lead any further. In fact, it's been cut into by two. And a foul on Love. And that is three on Love off the bench. A 10-point Kentucky lead here at Continental Airlines Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is the Jimmy V Classic presented by Mercedes-Benz. And our group has been here all afternoon and night seeing some great basketball. Kentucky's bench has done a sensational job tonight, especially Rashad Carruth, who hasn't played yet in the second half, but had 14 points. He's in there now. 14 points to lead Kentucky in the first half in scoring.
He was 5-for-6 in that first half and had a sensational half. If you look at Tubby Smith, you think about coaches, he's had 8 straight NCAA tournaments. Lute Olsen's got the most, 17, followed by John Chaney, 12, Roy Williams with 12, and Bob Huggins with 10, and then Tubby with 8, and Gary Williams and Kelvin Sampson with 8. They hook up against each other on Friday night, Oklahoma and Maryland.
Lead goes back to 12.
Buckner, brother of
Mr. Buckner, who played for Clemson, NBA.
Greg, his older brother, playing with Dallas. Love misses a reverse layup. Tayshaun Prince clears off the board.
I think he's got to get the starters back. Well, here they come. Here they come. He sent his message. Uh-oh, this would be a big possession right here. They got to come up with a stop.
Prince. Missed it. They do come up with a stop. Love with a rebound. Christensen bats in. Big fella scores.
I tell you what, the big spice eater inside. The veteran, he gets a few bumps. Big basket inside. Physical. Good low post play.
Here comes the starters, with the exception of Christensen's got to stay out there to shoot the free throw to try to get a three-point play.
Well, let's write the score down. He made the substitution at 54-44, 14 minutes on the clock. I'm going to watch Christensen down inside. There he is, a little drop step. Takes it up strong. He makes like R.J. Billis when Jay used to play in that post back there in the middle 1980s. Look at the reaction. Jay didn't react like that. Jay just expected to score.
Fired up senior. He's been around forever. Remember, he took a Mormon mission. So, actually, yeah. It's his seventh year at Duke. And he comes up with a big three-point play.
And Mr. Boozer comes in with three. I've got to give him a little confidence. Got the lead down into single digits.
That's the key, single digits. We've said it every time we've done a game, I think.
Well, they're going to get Duke's best shot right now. Kentucky's going to take Duke's best shot. This is like a heavyweight championship, man. This is like Frazier and certainly Mr. Ollie.
Almost thrown away. Hawkins picks up the loose ball.
I got goosebumps, man. I got goosebumps looking at this team. You see teams play. It's got a tournament fit. Flavor here.
Dunleavy picks up Hawkins. Duhon with a steal.
Uh-oh,
here comes Jones. And that might be an intentional foul.
They want to use
fouls on Bogans. Let's see.
I thought it should be intentional. They're going to say he went for the ball, but I thought it should have been intentional. Mike Krzyzewski feels the same way. They say he went for the ball. Watch the steal. And now we're going to see them go from defense to offense. Kick it out. There's Dante Jones going for the dunk. Oh, I don't know. Close.
Close. Jones only 2 points, now three.
That's the Dukies now. They want to see a little spark from their club. Tubby's had his kids ready to play. What a staff he was on with Ralph Woolard and Billy Donovan. Herb Sendick with Rick Pitino. Rick Pitino knows how to find people. Has he put his stamp already on that Louisville program?
No
in
doubt.
3 years, I'll tell you, they will be top 10 in America every year. And I know all the Cavs fans listening now don't want to hear me mention the name Mr. Pitino.
Five straight points for Duke.
What a motion in this building. What electricity on the court.
Tayshaun Prince.
He had it.
Pitch. They move it around the perimeter. Finally, Hawkins from the elbow.
I tell you, Mr. Hawkins has really earned some playing time at that point guard slot. Playing with some poise, playing defensively.
Great look inside Boozer, the quick move. Esto got a piece of it, though.
Hesitated inside right there. Tried to shoot the ball over the top, had no chance.
Esto, did he walk? Yes, he did.
They had a little help from some of the Duke players making a call, but Hawkins did a good job trying to find the open guy.
We're about 13 minutes from SportsCenter. Stuart Scott and Linda Cohn will be along. Grant Hill, another tough and rocky road for him.
Feel so bad for him. One of the classiest guys to wear an NBA uniform. Out again.
All the scores and highlights. Baseball, hockey, and NFL news. Dunleavy didn't get it. On a three, here comes the Cats.
Getting no second shot.
Caruth, he got it.
He's on fire. He is absolutely on fire. He was 5 for 6 in the first half. This diaper dandy has risen to the challenge. Duke is getting no second shots, Brad.
Underneath is Jason Williams.
He's going to start to take over. He's going to start to demonstrate his ability to get to the basket.
Whistle. Foul on Dante Jones, I believe, trying to stay with Caruth. Jones picks up his second.
We're going to watch them kick the ball out. They're running a transition game, spotting up for the three. That's part of the first phase of their transition game. Here's Carruth. Came in with a big-time reputation as a shooter.
The only thing Carruth may have done wrong when he came back down court, he went over to guard his man in front of the Duke bench and started woofing at all the players over there. Don't wake an angry Giant. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with you. Just play basketball. You don't need all that nonsense, talking that trash. You know, he missed a lot of time. He's out with an injury. Missed the first four games.
You know, one of the great things about that Kentucky break was that ball never hit the floor. A quick outlet and a pass ahead for the shot. An opportunistic three. That's an outstanding fast break.
And what a play in a post by Dunleavy. A great head fake and a ball fake for you young kids.
Dunleavy leads Duke with 14. The lead is 8 for Kentucky. We're under 12 minutes. Timeout taken by Tubby Smith.
I can't emphasize enough. We talked about it in the opening of the show, Brad, how important it was for Hawkins to have a big game. And he has responded at that point guard slot.
Has he ever? He's got 17 points to lead all scores. Everything we expected and then some at the 7th Jimmy V Classic, 59-51 Kentucky. Pam Valvano, Jim's wife with Fred Bearcat from the ACC.
Pam looks as good as ever. I'll tell you one thing. I got a hug and kiss from her at halftime.
I got one over the hotel. Remember to call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V, please, to help the V Foundation for Cancer Research. Give a call, make a donation. We'd appreciate it. Jimmy V and his family and his foundation obviously would as well.
Yeah, please make a call on behalf of Pam. She's been the architect of the V Foundation, which has raised over $22 million and over 140 grants. Call that number, 1-800-4-JIMMY-V.
59-51, 8th-ranked Kentucky in the nightcap of the Jimmy V Classic. Alabama won the opener by 3 over Temple. Tayshaun Prince, tough offensive rebound.
There it is again. Second and third opportunities, the story of the night. Kentucky wanting it a lot more than Duke.
Boozer, tough catch from Ewing. He missed in close, but he'll go to the free throw line as Fitch fouled it.
You cannot allow them to beat you on the glass the way they're getting beat and expect to get to the locker room with a W. I mean, Kentucky is just dominating inside, taking advantage of their size and their depth. There they are working the glass, and there's the versatility of Prince. What a player this kid is becoming. He's getting better and better with every game, his confidence soaring.
Carlos Boozer now double figures with 10.
I got a question for you. How good is Western Kentucky that they can go to Rupp Arena and beat this club by 12 on opening night?
Anybody that can beat Kentucky at Rupp's doing a day's work.
By double figures, they suffered a tough loss losing Chris Marcus to an injury. Dennis Fountain, one of the rising stars in coaching.
Kentucky by 9.
This kid playing with confidence. Look at this kid at the point. We talked about how important he was to this game.
Askill goes around Boozer and walked with it. You don't want him dribbling out 16 feet away from the hole, and he turns it over. That'll give it back to Duke when we come back. But the Blue Devils trail by 9.
He is one of the greatest of all the Dukies and a 6-time NBA All-Star. Why is the Magic Man now disappearing again? John Rocker and Carl Everett in the same clubhouse? SportsCenter, Stuart Scott and Linda Cohn after the game.
Jimmy V Classic, and it's been a classic performance by that young fella, Rashad Carruth. Fitch has done a great job on the boards. The backcourt of Kentucky's, we said, would be vital. It has been. Hawkins and Carruth have done a great job, and Fitch as well. And right now they lead 61-52. And Carruth has really been the story. The backcourt points for Kentucky is right now he's got 17 points. And in College Park, Georgia, I mentioned before he played at Oak Hill, he had a guy named Al Outlaw down there in Atlanta who taught him beef. Balance, eyes, elbow, and follow through. And I think he's working all that stuff pretty good.
I like that follow through you just demonstrated. Hey, I'll tell you this. We have not seen the patented Duke spurt yet. Duke is the best Spurs team in basketball. They're capable of going on a 14-1 run. We have not seen that. That's a credit to Kentucky's defense.
Underneath, Boozer strong. Dunleavy trying to tip it in. And then he can't come down with it. But there's a walk on Fitch.
And earlier this year, Duke was struggling shooting the three. They've gotten a lot better recently. Last year, they went dynamite from the three. I really believe they missed so much the communication ability, not only the talent, but maybe the best communicator, as Mike Krzyzewski has said, in Shane Battier.
Yep. No doubt. Can't lose a guy like that.
I tell you, that guy's unstoppable. It's an Eminem or a mismatch when he decides to take a guy one-on-one.
He may have to try to take the game over. And he's capable of doing that, too. Prince, nice spin around Dunleavy, then he lost the handle. And nobody's got the handle yet. Prince came up with it, got a timeout call. With 10:09 remaining in the ballgame, 61-54. Jason Williams leading right now Duke in scoring with 15. Three guys in double figures for the Blue Devil.
What makes him such a great driver is body strength and superb first step in getting to the basket. Great family, comes from a mom and dad, educated Ohio State grads.
Duke trailing by 7. Tomorrow night on ESPN2, it's the GMAC Bowl. It's Marshall. They've got a great quarterback. So does East Carolina, for that matter, David Girard. Should be a lot of points, a lot of fun. Marshall, Thundering Herd, ranked 25th in the country. 8 o'clock tomorrow night on ESPN2.
You know, we had a great game in that first game at the end. Alabama had to hang on to beat Temple at the end. Victory for the SEC. You know, you talk about surprises. What about Georgia? They're 9-1. Jimmy Herrick doing another great job.
Bogans rejected by Christensen.
Christensen really has given him some quality minutes. Had that basket on the inside, the low post, and then the block shot.
7 on the shot clock. Remember, they never got it up to the rim. Fitz does and missed it. And the rebound's Duhon. Outlet, tough one to Ewing. On the run, over a double team. Kamara blocked it.
Jules Kamara in Peru. The CNC gang has really connected for Kentucky.
Prince thought about a three. Here comes one from Fitz. And the backside rebound, Duhon. Back-to-back boards for him.
Duhon is not looking at the basket at all. He's too good of an offensive player to just delegate himself to giving it up. He's going to start looking a little offense.
Williams, pull-up jumper over Bogans, doesn't go. And Hawkins will slow it a bit for Kentucky with 9:15 remaining in the ballgame.
And having a good basketball IQ, understanding tempo, and that's what he's learning right now, Cliff Hawkins.
Now he'll take a three. Prince keeps it alive.
Got to back it out. It's not available.
There's an air ball. Two bad shots by Hawkins.
Yes, sir. Bad shot right there. Nice pass by Dunleavy.
Dunleavy to Williams. He got mugged by Kamara. He'll go to the free throw line.
That's a good foul by Kamara. Make him earn him at the free throw stripe rather than give him the sure layup.
Matt Christensen playing off the bench tonight for Duke. Came in as that five team replacement, and then now playing in there on his own merit. Nice stuff job by him.
You know, you watch him play the last few minutes that we've witnessed, you wonder why he doesn't get more playing time with his size. You watch Boozer getting taped up here from out of Alaska. Boy, Alaska's been good to Duke when you think about Trajan Langdon, the Alaska assassin, and Carlos Boozer.
Jason Williams now has 16 points. The lead's been cut down to 6 in the Jimmy V Classic in the nightcap. Number one team in the country trailing number 8. Brad Nessler, Dick Vitale, Jay Billis, John Saunders, Digger Phelps, and our whole crew here tonight in front of a packed house at Continental Airlines Arena. Jason knocks them both down.
I tell you, when you mention the programs, the storied programs at Duke, and Kentucky and North Carolina, certainly when I think of their uniform and the museum down there is so special as well.
Nice look underneath.
What a Ruth
again.
And there he is moving without the ball. We know he can shoot, but he's showing another dimension that he can play without the ball. That's the second time he's run a backdoor cut for a layup.
19 for Caruth. Williams through the lane trying to jam. Kamara got him again.
I smell a Duke run coming. This is a danger time right now for Kentucky.
You know what? They're in the middle of a 9-2 one right
now. Yes, sir. There they are with the little jam. You can really feel that Duke has stepped it up and got a little momentum going as you watch that backdoor cut by Caruth. That's a tough basket to make with the left hand on the inside. Tubby, one of 16. He's got 16 siblings.
Yep. Williams missed one.
Guys, Carlos Boozer twisted his ankle just a bit. He has been taped up by trainer Dave Englehart. He's expected to be back in the game.
All right, Jay. Jason Williams doesn't miss many free throws. Missed that last one. He has 17 points. Make it 18.
And O'Donnell's got to be up in the stands, chewing those nails, a little worried. She's such a great support to Tubby, just like Mickey is to Mike. And his children, Saul, is now playing in the development league, playing for Columbus. They're going to be on
down
TV
Georgia, yeah.
Christmas Eve.
There she is.
I know she's active, just like Mickey is for Duke. And I really have great respect for those wives. They worry and touch the poor people.
Caruth just couldn't quite handle the basketball there and turns it over.
Duke stepping it up a little bit more defensively. It's down to six.
Caruth, who tonight has shattered his previous best as far as career high. The best he'd ever done was 7 points, and he has 19. That seven was against VMI. This is a much bigger opponent and a much bigger night.
So I think Duhon's becoming too unselfish. I think he's got to look for his shot a little bit.
Dunleavy, there's a mismatch against Blevins. But Blevins does a nice job on defense.
1998, Duke had a 17-point lead. Looked like they were heading to the Final Four. And all of a sudden, Kentucky went on an unbelievable comeback. And they got a big shot out of Cameron Mills to put him ahead for the first time in that game and marched on to the finals and won the national title to give Tubby that national championship. Look at David Hobbs, former Alabama coach.
There's the guard scoring. Williams and Juhan together have just done 1 point better than Rajad Caruth, the freshman. Juhan gets a breather. Williams comes back in. Christensen sits down. And Boozer's back in with a retaped ankle.
Prince on the free throw line. I mentioned David Hobbs. Mike Sutton does a solid job on that sideline. And now Reggie Hanson is there as well. Former players, you look at that bench.
There they are. Mike to the right of your screen. David to the left of Tubby. And Prince hits both. And with 7:48 to go, it's an 8-point Kentucky lead.
The Jimmy B Classic is presented by Mercedes-Benz, located on the web at MBUSA.com.
Thanks to that young fella, Kentucky leads 65-57. If you're wondering how to help and get involved in the fight against cancer, we've got an opportunity for you. Log on to ESPNauctions.com. You can bid on some authentic memorabilia. All the proceeds go to the V Foundation. We've got some great basketball items up for bid. So get online, ESPNauctions.com.
And I'll tell you, those dollars really work, because we had a bunch of people that I had a chance to introduce who have beaten cancer with us. Our own Mark Kelly. Joyce Ashenbrenner works for the Lee Foundation.
Kind of like that thing that guy had. Go Duke, says in the little handheld cheer button. And he throws it away, though.
You talk about Duke dominance in the ACC. I can't believe these numbers. The last 4 years in the conference, 60-5. They lost 2 years in a row, though, at home to Maryland.
What a conference to be having that kind of record.
Oh, that's so impressive. Good man-to-man needed right here. There's the matchup, Dunleavy and Prince. Versatility is the name of their game, both guys. That's a five-second violation. Good defense. Got to give that ball up within a five-second count. It'd be 6 feet within you.
Tubby Smith just said to Tayshaun, give it up.
Tayshaun said, I'm a veteran player. He's not supposed to call that on me. Big possession right now. Duke's got to get a spark. They got to get a score. Chris Duhon's not even looking at the basket. He just wants to be settled. He's passing the basketball. He's
nice pass by Dunleavy. Boozer chance for a three-point play.
Carlos Boozer on the inside. He's got an assortment of moves on the interior. I tell you, Michael Dunleavy's game is so complete. He can step outside and shoot a three. He can handle the ball. He can pass the basketball. Look at Boozer showing some enthusiasm.
Carlos has got 12.
He and Jason Williams most likely to be going to the NBA draft at the end of this year. They've made that announcement basically already.
Again, the lead is sliced down to six with 6:44 remaining.
He's picking his dribble up a little too soon, J.P. Blevins. You don't want to do that.
Kamara thought about a three. And instead tries to pass it to Prince, and Dunleavy comes flying in there to break it up.
Did a great job stepping in the passing lane, Michael Dunleavy. Duke was in a recruiting war. Was going to either be Dunleavy or a Mr. Jacobson playing out there for Stanford. Not a bad combo to be after.
No doubt about that. 15 on the shot clock now because they didn't get a shot away. Bogans trying to get it to Kamara. Now they're running out of time. 5 on the clock. Caruso's going to have to be the guy if he realizes the clock's winding down. And shot clock violation. He missed the rim.
You know, the last two possessions, Kentucky has not been able to get a shot. Duke has really elevated its game defensively.
6:19 left. Here comes Hawkins back in.
I think that's a good move. Hawkins really has responded today to the challenge. And I think the quickness of the game gives him the edge in this matchup. And Blevins is a great team player. I loved his quotes today. He said, hey, I'm not upset that he's going to start.
Right.
The bottom line is we're going to play and I want to win.
Williams pull up for three.
Got it. Big time shot by a big time player. Here come the Dukies. Will Kentucky have enough to hold off the Dukies?
Williams three is cut into three.
Oh, baby, we got ourselves a Bailock smasher.
Hawkins walked with it.
Three possessions in a row, Brad. They haven't got a shot. They have run into a defense that has elevated its game.
This game's enough to give you a nosebleed.
Woo!
65-62.
This Boozer with the screen.
Williams.
He just feels it now. He wants the rock in his hand. Jason Williams is saying, I want to take us to the winner's locker room. Get me the rock, baby. There he is now going to pull up. And that's what makes him so unique as a point guard. There aren't many NBA point guards that can regularly knock down the trifecta. Look at the emotion. Chris Collins, a coach, hitting the floor, saying, let's play some D, baby. Oh, I love this.
Williams with 21.
Have such respect for both programs.
Knocks it down.
Respect for both coaches. Respect for all the star players here tonight.
Jason, who played his high school ball at St. Joseph's in Plainfield, and I said before the game, hey, Jace, how many people you got here tonight? He said, I don't know, don't want to know. Not thinking about that, just thinking about winning.
Well, hoping you got to get a lot of tickets, man. It cost them a lot of money because there's no freebies. Oh, Boozer hurt his ankle. Boozer hurt his ankle.
Well, that one was retaped.
He looks like he hurt his ankle.
Hawkins baseline. No go. Rebound.
Oh, what a break for Williams. What a break for Blevins. Oh, awesome, baby, with a job of the leg. Duhon with a great play. Oh, this is unbelievable. Are you telling me this is the summer run? That's the homie down.
Prince tried to jam it. And Dunleavy had to foul it.
Oh, my God, I can't believe it.
Prince went up hard, came down hard, still trying to move his left shooting hand.
Did you see the pass by Duhon? The anticipation with the left hand. Look at the left hand as he flips it out to his buddy. And there's Williams going to finish it off.
And on the other end, Dunleavy goes hard.
Oh.
Prince doesn't get the jam.
Oh, two super players going head-to-head there. Dunleavy and Prince.
Prince now has 10.
As Billy Raftery said, and I couldn't agree more, Prince has become a king.
Tayshaun with 10 points on the night.
Yeah, Boozer hurt that ankle.
Got them both.
They're going to have a jump trying to win this game without Mr. Boozer.
Here we go. Final 5:15. It's 67-65. Kentucky. Williams got a pick. And he buried a three.
He's Mr. Clutch. He's Mr. Automatic. He wants the rock when the game is on the line. That's why he's a PTP.
First Duke lead since there was 4:41 left in the first half.
We said I thought I was going to see a spark come, a spurt. And there's that spurt, Brad.
Prince turns. It rattled out on him. Bogans had a hand on it. Now Fitz comes up with it. He gets
fouled. He got fouled. Bogans has not been able to elevate his game here tonight. He's got to step up at a winning time now, make some big plays, the veteran player. Look at the screen. Look at the free. Right there. See that screen right there? He's coming right as tight to it. He comes right off that screen of Sanders. And that's all he needs is that one little second to get free off the screen. Jason Williams. As good as it gets.
27 points for Williams.
He said the other day, Lionel Richie said all night long, and that's Jason when he gets the rock in his hands. I played that on a convertible.
I know you did.
Driving down to Siesta Key Beach.
Fitch got them both. Fitch is one tough competitor. He's a defensive player, good rebounder, as you said earlier. They can't exclusively just think they're going to go inside and just look for Williams. Some other people got to step up as well.
Duhon, Prince falls down. Duhon's going to take it. Battle for the rebound. Who's going to get it? Boy, they fight.
I'll tell you, here's where I hate this rule. Here's where I hate this rule. I mean, alternate possession. Now it goes over to Duke. Kids are hustling. We should be able to throw the ball up like we showed earlier this year in those games that we had, the exempt games earlier this season.
A one-point Kentucky lead. Duke's 19-game winning streak on the line. They're the number one team in the country. That as well on the line here in the Jimmy B Classic. And this has been a dandy. Kentucky led by three at halftime, and they lead right now by one.
Well, you know, Duke twice this year has had to come from behind, has been able to win. A tough win against Seton Hall. Louis Orr's club was so ready in that game. Weavers made a great steal at the end of the game. Not really beyond. They were down 9 in the first half with Ball State and ultimately had too much. Ball State's got a big one tomorrow against undefeated Butler.
I thought Williams was going to take it right off the inbounds pass. He almost did. Hoosier trying to get it to Dunleavy. He had it knocked out of bounds.
Two kids have played a lot of minutes. But they love that. They're young. They're resilient.
Got it.
Love it.
30 for Williams.
Is he a big timer, Brad? Is there any doubt he's the best player in America?
Not in my mind. 2-point Duke lead. Bogans ties it up.
And Bogans answers, and that's what you expect out of a kid like Bogans. In traffic, comes up with the score. It's been a quiet night for him, a little silent night.
Oh, we seventh tie of the ball game, second this half.
Using that screen really well, that high screen.
Williams threw that one away, and now Dunleavy has become foul prone. He's got four here in about the last 6 minutes.
Yeah, he definitely caught him. There's no question, good call by the official. It's going to come down to free throw shooting at the end of the game. Jason Williams does a great job moving there without the ball to get free for the jump shot.
So 71 apiece as Fitch goes to the free throw line.
There's so much pride on the court. You can feel the pride that the kids have wearing those jerseys that represent so much greatness. You wear that jersey, it becomes contagious. You're not only representing yourself, you're representing all the greats that have worn that jersey in the past.
Fitch can move into double figures now if he hits this. Pretty good for a guy that was only 6 out of 12 coming in on the season from the line. He hit a boat. He's given Kentucky a 2-point lead. Kentucky leading by 2. The Jimmy V Classic presented by Mercedes-Benz. 3:38 remaining. Jason Williams has been the star. There's his parents, his mom, Althea. On the left is a high school principal in Plainfield, New Jersey.
And a dad, they both went to Ohio State, both Buckeyes. How did the Buckeye alumni
allow
that to get away?
I'm not sure.
They say that he was actually crying in the car. She was driving down to Durham with him to visit because he really was thinking about staying at home and wanted to stay at Rutgers. Can you imagine?
I think mom's got a little prayer going right now. She's cheering with her eyes shut.
They would have had possibly Dante Jones and Jason Williams and Troy Murphy, who went to Notre Dame. There was rumors all three were going to hook up.
Well, win or lose, Chris Duhon's mom here. Win or lose. Jason Williams has been nothing short of sensation.
I mean, I love Chris Duhon, his defensive ability, his ball handling skills, but I still think he's a little unselfish. He's got to think a little more offense.
Dunleavy for the lead. Nope. Rebound, Fitch. And
Bogans got called for a foul.
Yeah, Bogans got called for the foul.
Bogans got called for a push-off. Not a good foul there by a veteran.
Nope.
In that situation when you got the basketball, it's four on him as well.
He's had a tough night.
He really has. He struggled in this game. He struggled against North Carolina, but they didn't need him because his buddy Tayshaun went on an unbelievable run, knocking down 5 threes in a row to start the game. He only had a deuce in that game.
Dante Jones will step up to the free throw line now out of Trenton, New Jersey.
I'll tell you, he made a wise decision coming back to school, Keith Logan.
No doubt.
There's no doubt he would have been all vagabond traveling from one league after another. He wasn't ready for life in the NBA. Made a world-class Albert Einstein team, making a good decision along with guys like Kevin Lyde, and Jason Gardner, and Jerry Green, and Cal Irvine.
Dante Jones, who has pressed a little too hard, I think, at times in front of the hometown fans, can tie this basketball game up with this free throw.
That's a good assessment. I really believe he's come back home here, transferred from Rutgers, trying to impress everyone. And he started off out of the game really struggling.
73 apiece.
See him slap the floor. That's a trademark of Duke. That means get down and play some dirty D, man. Play some tough, dirty D. I mean dirty in a standpoint, just hard, tough.
French with Dunleavy on it.
Whoa, almost away. Shot selection is so important when you get to winning time like this, Brad. Taking a good shot and getting the right people to shoot the ball.
10 seconds on the shot clock, 3 to play in the game.
This kid's been on fire.
Hawkins, great look to Kamara. Boozer will clear off the miss.
That was a tremendous look inside. Kamara didn't finish the play.
He's too high for the lead. Missed it. And Prince with a rebound. 73-73 it remains.
Elon says we like to be on top of the mountain and everyone wants to knock us off, but we're not going to let them knock us off. Kentucky may have a different answer here tonight.
Fitch. Daniels cut off by Boozer. Going to work it down under 10 on the shot clock again. Fitch will take it. Missed it. Rebound is Boozer's.
That's a big-time rebound right there. He wanted that. I would go inside to Boozer, get him some touches inside, and maybe go inside outside.
Duke takes a timeout.
Oh, it's everything we thought.
2:10 remaining, tied at 73.
I always say, don't judge a man until you see what...
Stuart Scott, Linda Connor standing by in about 2 minutes, barring overtime. Downhill for Grant. Rangers off their rocker. Cardinals trying to replace Big Mac. Those stories and more on SportsCenter in a couple minutes. Brad Nessler, Dick Vitale, Jay Billis, John Saunders, Digger Phelps, and our crew at East Rutherford, New Jersey for the Jimmy V Classic, and it has been one. Boozer underneath. Kamara got it.
The decision, I told you before they went to the timeout, you got to go inside to Boozer. Go inside to him. He's got an assortment of moves on the interior. Tubby Smith's got a great effort tonight out of his kids, but he doesn't want a moral victory. He's going to watch the pump fake inside. He spreads his body. Well, see the fake? See young guys out there? You use the ball fake and the head fake, and 90% of the time you'll get fouled. Now you got to convert on that free throw line.
He's only 2 of 5 from the stripe tonight. 84% on the season, though. And he just can't find it tonight.
Well, his leg might be bothering that ankle, and you have to use your legs on your shot. People don't realize how important that leg is. Duke knows. They're really concerned on that sideline.
Bogans and Carruth run back in for Kentucky in between free throws, and Daniels and Fitch sit.
You know, people were talking unbeaten, unblemished. Duke is like unbeatable. Well, let me tell you something. So difficult to go unbeaten, and you talk about that now, it's too early. Are they capable? Obviously, they haven't been beaten. But let me tell you, to try and do that with a schedule eight play facing teams like Maryland, very, very difficult.
One of the 8 unbeaten teams remaining in the United States. Will they still be unbeaten in a minute and 48 seconds? We'll find out.
You want to be unbeaten in March, though, I'll tell you that.
Prince up high, got it.
That's what big-time players do, and he certainly won. He wants the ball late as well, just like Mr. Williams.
Kentucky by 1. 1.5 minutes to play. Williams looking for a screen. Goes back to Boozer inside. They move it around. Duhon gave up an open shot. Here's Williams. He'll take it. He got it.
What a big time play in reversing the basketball. The mom jumps with joy. Her son shows why he's America's premier college player. What a classic game. Kentucky at Duke.
33 for Jason Williams. What a night. 1 minute to play. 75. And for Kentucky, 77 for Duke. Rebound, Kamara's got it. And he is fouled, I think. Yep, foul.
That was a great rebound by Kamara in traffic.
to go up and get that rebound in traffic. That was good. Now look at Prince. He says, I'm going to show you why I'm an All-American. The long arms from out of California. Tickles the twine. And now on the other end, Jason Williams says, hey, anything you can do, Mr. Prince, I can do better. I'm going a little further down with an AT&T special.
Kamara missed the free throw.
And the mom says, that's my guy, that's my Jason. She does a little dance.
And back on the live action, Jules Kamara under pressure at the line. Has missed his last two. Got the second one. 10 points for Kamara. It's a one-point game.
E. Hawkins and Caruth have really stepped up tonight. We know about Prince, but those three have really escalated their game to another level. Everybody's standing up.
45 seconds left. Williams working against Hawkins. Williams got a leg up. Throws it out to Duhon for three. Rebound. Whose is it? Kentucky ball.
Reverse rolls right there. Duhon usually kicking it out to Jason. They reversed it.
Shot clock is off. If they can handle it well, they can play for the win.
And here we go. They need a defensive stop. You got to believe it's got to be Prince that they got to get the ball to. There he is.
Tayshaun against Dunleavy, who's played him well defensively tonight.
They're going to take the big screen. They want Prince to shoot it.
Prince in the paint. Got it.
Yes, he delivers, but there's plenty of time on the clock.
Kentucky by one.
Let's see if Williams got an answer for it. Tayshaun.
Timeout.
Oh, there's nervous time in Lexington right now and nervous time in Durham, North Carolina.
The eighth lead change in the last 5 minutes has Kentucky in front by one, courtesy of their SEC Player of the Year, Tayshaun Prince.
Isn't it great to see the two big stars respond to the challenge? Here's Tayshaun responding big time to the challenge. Right into the 3 second area. There was no doubt that they were going to put the ball in his hands. With a great change of direction, he's able to get by Dunleavy, and there's the left hand, the smooth, silky smooth. Oh, and there's jubilation. Jubilation on the bench. They jump with joy. Look at Tubby. Tubby says, hey, we designed it that way. We designed it.
I mentioned eight undefeateds left. Duke being one of them and being the number one team in the country. Virginia, the highest scoring team in the country. Oklahoma State, Boston College, Marquette, Barry Clark's Miami Club, Butler, and Mississippi State from the SEC.
I'll tell you, Oklahoma State has been outstanding all year with Maurice Baker. Marquette with Dwayne Wade, one of the premier new players on it in America. Mississippi State has beaten a lot of cupcakes. We'll find out how good they are on Friday against Cincinnati.
Here's the ball game. 14.7 seconds remaining. Duke trails by one.
And you got to believe the ball. Something's going to happen with Jason Williams. He's just going to create an opportunity for someone on the floor, or he's going to take the last shot. I got to believe that somehow going to get the ball in the hands. Somebody wants a timeout after seeing the alignment.
So Kentucky heads back to its bench. One of the great games ever was between these two clubs. Better than this one, if you can believe it. March of 92. Do you remember it? The East Regional Final.
Wood takes it down the right side, fires it up. It goes with 2 seconds left. Timeout Duke. Sean Woods has put the Kentucky Wildcats up by one. They throw it to the left of the floor. Leitner catches, comes down, dribbles, shoots, scores! Rick out, Minneapolis. Here come the Blue Devils.
Duke prevails 104-103 in what most consider, if not the greatest, arguably the greatest game in college basketball history. And I'll tell you, you want to pick one out for December, whatever today is, this one ain't bad.
I'll tell you, but there was a lot more obviously at stake in that game. It was the NCAA tournament. I mean, not at stake here is that, but there's a lot of bragging rights. And psychologically, it'd be such a great win for either program getting a big W here today. But that was such a magical moment when Leitner made that shot. And then in 98, as I said earlier, Duke was dominating with 9 minutes on the clock. There's Donna. That's Tubby's wife. I tell you, the wives really suffered. But they were dominating. They came back. Kentucky to win that game. There's the reset. There's the timeouts.
Both teams over the limit. Fouls, possession arrows, Kentucky's. Jason Williams has been the man. He's got to touch it somewhere in here. Will he be the guy to take the shot?
You know, some people will say, well, Jason Williams, obviously, they're going to defend him. They're going to really come after him. Well, great players have a way of responding to that and getting the ball in a crunch time.
The ball game between the eighth and first-ranked teams in the country is right here in front of you, folks. 14 seconds left.
And here's the screen for him.
He got a good pick from Dunleavy. Goes to the hole. It's blocked, but he's fouled.
He got fouled, taking it to the goal. No doubt that he was going to get the ball, but a great foul to make him have to make the free throws because he was in for the layup.
Tayshaun Prince is holding his hands up as if to say, what else could I do? I blocked the shot.
He was in for the layup. He was right there. Had the defensive seal, and there comes Kamara over from the weak side.
Williams has not shot particularly well tonight from the free throw line. Comes in as a 71% free throw shooter on the year. And got that one.
Gets the bounce to go his way.
It's a tie game at 78.
Here's Bob saying a few prayers right there. This is reminiscent at the end how he made a great play against Maryland when he came back. Uh-oh.
He missed that one, Kamara.
It's time on that clock.
Let's see. Tayshaun Prince. 5 seconds. Kentucky can win. No. We're going to overtime.
And that's the way it should be. As long as I get there to make my flight tomorrow at 5 a.m. to leave here, let's stay here all night. Let's stay here all night. I don't want to leave, Brad. Let's play all night.
Overtime at the Meadowlands. We're tied at 78. The classic couldn't be any more classic than this one. 78-78. We're in overtime. As Tayshaun Prince fouled Jason Williams, but he only got one of two free throws. Tubby Smith is pretty darn good in overtime at Kentucky.
7-1, it's not bad, is it? Oh, Jimmy Valvano, I'll tell you what, he'd be dancing like you couldn't believe here tonight. He would love this whole scene.
Overall, in overtime games in an 11-year coaching career, Tubby Smith is 15-4. Mike Krzyzewski's been there many times before as well. And here we go, we're not done yet.
Now you talk about minutes, certainly when you look, you would say, well, the Duke kids have to be a little bit more fatigued. They've played so many more minutes, but they've been doing that throughout their career. Last year, the same thing. I kept hearing that same cry from everyone. They're acclimated to that.
Boozer and Kamara will jump. Andre Patillo will throw it up as he did about 2 hours and 10 minutes ago. Kamara gets the tip. Dunleavy runs into Prince. He comes up with the ball.
That we said early, that Duke had to lace him up tonight and really come to play against this fired up Kentucky team.
Williams missed the outside jumper. And stepped on the baseline. Yep.
It is so difficult to criticize Jason sometimes with some of the shots he takes because he's so talented and so good. But there are times that there's one part of his game is understanding a little better shot selection. I guess we're going to give a guy a license.
I was going to say. Trying to spin a pass inside. Dante Jones picks up the loose ball.
Oh, he comes up with the loose ball on the interior. Dante Jones has become a defensive stopper. He's done a heck of a job defensively on Bogut. You got to remember that now.
And a foul on Duhon.
They got a little lucky bounce their way to Dukies in that possession. As the ball inside, looks like it's going to be a turnover. And it goes right into Dante Jones' hands. He's been a defensive catalyst and playing Bogut's really tough tonight.
So Cliff Hawkins, a sophomore, goes to the free throw line. 6-point night for him. And he rims it out. I mentioned earlier, Stu and Linda were standing by barring overtime. I remember saying that at the 210 mark. I'm sorry to jinx y'all, but you guys got to wait.
That's a heck of a combination, Stu and Linda. Stu out there. I know he's a North Carolina guy. I wonder who he's cheering for. Is he cheering for the Dukies? I don't think so.
He'll let us know.
I don't think so.
80-79, Duke in front. Williams guarded by Hawkins.
Very tough to handle him one-on-one. You got to get a lot of help.
Against Prince, blocked. Dunleavy to follow.
Again, Duke in the right place at the right time. Dunleavy just like Dante Jones in a previous possession.
Mike Dunleavy has 16. The lead is 3 for Duke. Hawkins on a fadeaway over Duhon. Got it.
Big time shot right there by Cliff Hawkins. I think you're going to see this kid become the answer to their so-called dilemma that people talk about at the point guard slot.
82-81.
He just needs some playing time.
Williams kicks outside. Nice ball movement around the perimeter for Dunleavy. And Boozer keeps it alive. Mike was going to try another one. Now he drives, and he's fouled.
Mike Dunleavy is so solid fundamentally. He gets caught with a charge.
He does.
Is that five?
Nope, that's four. I was wrong earlier when I said that he had four. He does now.
Gets in a triple threat position where he's going to face the defensive player. That's what you kids want to do. Face the defensive player. You can drive, pass. Oh, I don't know about the charge there. I don't know about the charge there. Oh, I don't know about that. I agree with you, Mike.
3:22 left. 82-81 Duke. Kentucky can change the score again if Hawkins hits this. Prince does.
Tayshaun Prince with a variety of ways to score. That little jump hook inside. Again, we saw excellent penetration ability out of Hawkins.
Each team now has led in overtime. 3 minutes to play in OT. Williams needs some help. Duhon comes out to help him.
Carlos Boozer's got to get a touch inside.
Jason Williams looking for a screen. He keeps running into bigger people.
Boozer.
Boozer, Dunleavy, long ball, got it.
See, you get the touch inside the Boozer, and you create the open shot. They give help, he kicks it out, they got the little triangle.
Dunleavy has 19. The lead is 2 for Duke.
Hawkins doing one heck of a job penetrating, getting the ball in the lane. I tell you, the kids at Duke really are so well coached in how to reverse the basketball. Watch them swing the ball side to side. We're going to see right here, there's the entry inside. And now look at the ball movement. Kick it back out, and there's the wide open hand. A nice little triangle there offensively. Two guys up on top and Boozer inside.
Cliff Hawkins has 10 points now. And Mike Krzyzewski saying, come on, guys, let's go.
Does he want it or what? I mean, the guy, 9 Final Fours, 3 national titles, but it's not enough, and that's what competitors are all about.
Hawkins missed the second. Williams, quick pass to Dudley.
Great look, great vision. You young kids, keep your eyes up all the time. Don't look at the ball. Great vision by Jason Williams.
Back to a 3-point lead. Now for the tie off the glass.
Oh, did he call that? Is the bank open?
He'll take it.
Did he call that, baby?
Tied at 87 in overtime with 2 minutes left in OT.
Classic.
Williams fouled by Hawkins.
I can't wait to sit down tomorrow, have all my papers, have breakfast, and read about this baby. Oh, it's a dandy one. There's that great look. Look at that look inside to Dunleavy. Good two-man game. And right here, Hawkins. Right from up on top. Right off the bank, just like Sean Winston. Right off the glass.
Williams.
You know who'd have loved this? Hayward loved it. Oh,
yes,
would have loved to be calling this baby. One of the greats.
And I'm only place Jason Williams is struggling tonight is from the free throw line.
I guess we're allowed to have that up.
Five out of nine. He's just matched his career high. 35 points.
And I mean everyone is needed. You get 35 and win by 30. That's a different ball game, baby. That's what Oscar Robinson used to get 40 and win by one.
Hawkins taking over for Kentucky.
Will somebody tell him he's not supposed to be a star? That he is supposed to be fighting for a starting job? The kid has become a star.
Jason Williams drives to the hole. Got it. Chance for a 3-point play.
Are you serious? I don't want my check after this, baby. To sit here and call this. Jason Williams, give me a break. Give me a break.
37 points.
Nobody's supposed to be that good. Watch Jason Williams, a little change of direction.
This is just plain strength at the end of this thing.
What a halfback he would be in football, Brad. Would he be one heck of a halfback?
38 points, Jason Williams.
And what's special, they need every one of them. They need every one of them.
Still not over. 1:39 left, Duke in overtime by 2.
jacket, but it might be one of his buddies, because that's the year he graduated from St. Joseph's in Plainfield, New Jersey. Tonight, he has taken over the country in his junior season in college basketball. A career high 38 points, and he has given Duke right now a two-point lead, 91-89 in overtime.
I tell you, it's been unbelievable. Well, I can simply say, awesome day, Beulah Capital A. I'm just so honored to be able to sit here and to witness this as you watch Jason Williams. Look at that strength as he goes to the rack. Now watch him right here explode, stop on a dime, and knock down the trifecta. And look at the vision with the great pass inside to Dunleavy. Jason Williams, the complete player. Great change of direction. I really believe when you talk point guards in America, there aren't any better, with the exception of the one guy that plays here, Jason Kidd.
You saw him hit the floor. Hawkins launched a three, didn't get it. Here's Carruth. He was a big score in the first half. Hawkins all alone. Gave up a three, drives, and missed again.
Tell you one thing, he's not afraid. Now look who comes up with the rebound. Jason Williams.
Hawkins had scored 9 of the 11 points for Kentucky in overtime, but he missed twice that trip down court.
And they were two good shots. I mean, they weren't bad shots.
Williams way out court with Hawkins on him. 1:05 to go in overtime.
Going to try to use that screen up on top and release Boozer for a layup.
Give and go to Boozer. Got it.
There it is. You can see it coming. He was going to release Boozer for the layup. Williams again. He gets the rebound. He makes the pass and makes the play.
Neither team should have to win or lose this game.
That's reminiscent of the game in 92. Doesn't have a stake with
that. Carruth, three. Off the mark. Jones rebound. Foul. I think it's on Duke, though. It is. It's on Dante Jones. 4-point lead is the biggest of overtime.
You could see this play coming. I mean, it was right there. A two-man play. They executed so well. The screen, the release to the basket by Boozer. Great two-man game. Inside-outside combination.
Keith Bogans rips a free throw. Fitch comes back in. Carruth goes out.
Talk about the great inside-outside combos. You have to talk about Williams and Boozer as maybe the best. And then there's Haslam and certainly Nelson and Dixon and certainly Baxter.
Keith Bogans hits two big free throws with 43.8 seconds remaining in overtime.
And this baby is far from over.
Duke 93, Kentucky 91. With 43.8 remaining in the ballgame. Stuart Scott, Linda Cohn standing by Sports Center. They'll have all the scores and highlights. Story on Grant Hill, who apparently another surgery in his season done. Some baseball, hockey news, NFL highlights, college football. Also involved with the bowl season starting tonight. And all you want to do is be on SportsCenter for Christmas. Well, I don't know if your folks or family could see you, but your sign was on.
Merry Christmas. Happy New Year to you and all your family, Brad, and everybody out there. God bless, and God bless America. Have a great holiday.
Boy, this is a nice way to kick off the holidays. You and I will be back to see Duke on ABC on the 29th against San Diego State. And I don't think it'll be as good as this one.
Steve Fisher's got to come in. Well, here we go now. They need a stop right here.
Duhon brings it up slowly against Fitch.
Kentucky's got to come out with a great defensive stop. This is a major possession.
Kamara knocked it away.
He deflected it.
15 on the shot clock, 23 on the game clock. Williams with it. Hawkins on him.
Spacing so important.
He got away from Hawkins momentarily. Dunleavy outside. Missed it. But the rebound is Jones.
Dante Jones. Here he is at home in New Jersey. The Rutgers transfer with the biggest basket he's ever made at Duke.
Kentucky's got to hurry. Hawkins forces a three. Duke's going to hold on with 0.3 left. They're going to win it.
What a great basketball game. A salute to Kentucky and all its fans, its kids, its players. Just a great performance here tonight. But at the end, it was just too much. Jason Williams.
Jason Williams, 38 points. As some of the Kentucky players hang their head, as I said, nobody deserves to go home with anything but a W out of this thing. Our Mercedes-Benz player of the game in his home state, Jason Williams.
with a career performance, 38 points, 7 three-pointers. He was as good as you can see.
As good as you can get it. Everyone would need it. My sign of a great player and an All-American is when you score 35 and 38 and your team needs every one of them, that is special. And that's what we witnessed here tonight. We witnessed tonight the kid that would have been the number one player in the NBA draft said, no, baby, I'm not going to the NBA. I'm staying in college.
Jones, Dante Jones, the other New Jersey native, just came up with a huge garbage rebound, if you will. And not only that, but the all-important two that followed it. And that's basically what's going to win it for Duke, because there's only 0.3 seconds left. And there's not a heck of a lot that Kentucky can do about it. There's just not enough time.
That's the biggest basket he has made at Duke, Dante Jones.
And still coaching and still huddled around Mike Krzyzewski, who said, you know what? We're not a great team, but we're a pretty good team. Well, I think they showed greatness in their comeback, if nothing else.
Look at that intensity. Look at that intensity. Banging the floor, really into it big time.
Duke trailed by 3 at halftime. In the second half, they also trailed by as many as 12. They came back and tied it at 78 to end regulation. And now they are 4 points up with 0.3 seconds to go.
You know, it's pretty hard to say, but he could go down maybe as the greatest guard ever to play a Duke. And think about the greats that have worn the Duke uniform.
No doubt about it.
You can go back to Dick Grohl and certainly think about Jeff Mullins and all the greats that aren't Heyman. You could think about certainly all the supers like Bob Hurley and Grant Hill was more of a swing man. But
Johnny Dawkins, Tommy
Johnny
Amateur.
Dawkins, oh, it's unbelievable. But I'm telling you, Brad, I haven't seen anybody that could do it better on both sides of the floor, score, pass as he can.
When they were down a dozen in the second half and Mike Krzyzewski took his whole crew out and put in a fresh 5 players.
Was that guts or what?
When he came back in, we said Jason Williams is going to have to take over the game. Folks, he took over the game.
Nobody lost tonight, my friends. This was one special evening for everybody.
What a great game. Jason Williams, 38 points. Duke wins it. The number one team in the country's won 20 in a row. Final score in overtime from New Jersey, 95-92 Duke. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. SportsCenter is next.